Hello, everybody. Happy St. Patrick's Day to all. We want to go ahead and commemorate St. Patrick's Day by playing one of the most vicious battles in Irish history. Yes, indeed, this was one of the darkest periods of Irish history, but to this day, it's, of course, a battle that's remembered both by the Republic of Ireland as well as Northern Ireland, a pretty important part of the history itself of the Glorious Revolution. Now, we're going to be playing as the Jacobites, and these are the supporters of the deposed King James II of England. He was a Catholic, and so were his supporters. We're currently fighting against the Williamites, and these are supporters of William III of Orange, who became King of England after the Glorious Revolution. He was a Protestant, and so were his supporters. Now, I'm sure there were a few, outliers that were Protestant that supported possibly James II, and probably Catholics that also supported William. It really wasn't entirely 100% Catholics versus Protestants, but for the most part, it was. So as you can see, after the inconclusive campaign of 1989, William, Prince of Orange, took personal command of his army and advanced on Dublin. James II resolved to confront the Williamites at the River Boyne. This had the unexpected result of drawing off the bulk of the Jacobite army to face the new threat, leaving a small force under Duke of Tyrconnell to hold the main crossing at Old Bridge against overwhelming odds, guys. So William sent part of his force on a flank march to the west to try and cross the river and turn the Jacobite flank. After having outmaneuvered themselves, the Jacobites had no choice other than retreat back down the road to Dublin. So we're trying to essentially hold this position as long as we can against William of Orange. I do believe, and I could be mistaken on this, I know for a fact that William of Orange was actually at this battle. I think Jacob II also was. But essentially, these were definitely battles where a lot of the leadership was present. So we're going to go ahead. I'm getting the chance here to, of course, move my men first. And I can see a few possible crossings, one of them being Grove Island over here. Let's take a look. I'm just going to get my men sort of set up across from Grove Island just to make absolutely sure that if the enemy attacks, I'm going to be ready for them. And we've got the Duke of Tyrconnell here prepared for that crossing. We've also got a crossing over here on this side of Grove Island. So I want to send some men over there as well. And these are dragoons. So they are cavalry, but they are armed cavalry with rifles. I could definitely do some damage. Over here on the far right flank, we've got one unit of piquettes that are watching Milford. Let's hope that the enemy doesn't choose to cross at Milford, but we're going to end the turn and turn it over to the Williamites. All right, it looks like they already have some artillery. We have absolutely no artillery, as you can imagine. And you can see that the Williamites' forces are moving forward. So here we go. We're going to have to face them in some way, but I'm going to let them get into our sight first. I'm not going to cross the river to face them or anything like that. I'm going to let them cross the river and hopefully suffer as a result. So one thing, we've got James, a guard of foot, and I'm going to move him over here. I think he would be a much more effective shot. I think we should move this James guard of foot as well. Yes, we're moving away from the obstacle, but we're at least getting close enough where we could do some damage to the enemy. And we're also going to bring the Earl of Antrim's foot forward as well. Also want to keep in mind, this is a user-made scenario, user-made map. So anybody could, if they have enough time and obviously the skill, you could make a map like this about, some sort of war or battle that you have in mind of this time period, time of the 30 Years' War, that perhaps could really be featured and put on our YouTube channel. So keep that in mind. It's definitely something to look forward to. So we're going to go ahead and end the turn here once again. All right, the Williamites are moving forward. Nice shot by the Williamites, I have to admit. That was pretty devastating. And this, of course, is a foot guard. I'm not sure they have any sort... Oh, nice shooting. I'm not sure they have any sort of muskets, but we just got a beautiful shot on the Williamites there. So it is now the Jacobite turn in Ireland here. And we're going to turn and open fire on the Guards de Fouettes, 1st Battalion. Nice, 15. I'm going to try to open fire again. And we're going to try to get that last shot with James Foot Guard, 2nd Battalion. So we're already doing quite a lot of damage to that first line of enemy. And I think that's going to be very helpful in the overall battle. But we've got to start getting every single one of our units forward here to defend this area. Although I don't want to get complacent. If he starts sending units up here, I'm going to have very little to actually face him. Let's move these guys forward as well. We will end the turn. So I'm very happy that we don't have to cross the bridge, but that artillery is devastating to us. As you can see, taking 15 casualties from that one shot, I mean, that is definitely going to hurt us in the end. All right, let's see. It looks like one of these units may be going for that central position. Once again, we're continuing to fight, but the enemy is not really phased as of right now. So once again, it is the Jacobite turn. I am going to turn. I hope that we can fire at this distance, and indeed we can. Beautiful. Let's keep it up. Another shot. If we could turn one of these units, we're already on the first steps to victory, but we haven't even disrupted this unit yet. So it's going to take a lot of work here to make a difference, I think. I'm going to watch this guy because I don't know what he's going for. I'm even tempted to bring the mounted PKs over here just to scout the enemy, but I know that's probably not a good idea. Let's just go ahead and end the turn. Looks like they've already noticed that we're trying to put all of our men across the river here. Unbelievable shots on the Williamites, but it's not phasing them one bit. And there we go. We've got some more Williamite forces approaching. Huguenot foot, and they're definitely going to be heading, I think, for that middle part, that middle island, if I had to guess. All right, no melee as of yet, of course, but we're going to keep putting the pressure on these guys, hopefully breaking them before they make it across. We could charge, but actually our chances of winning are quite small, so we really need to be careful if we're going to charge at all. Let's fire again. 24, and they're still not breaking, although that flag is becoming... There we go, auto breaks, finally. Finally, we managed to auto-break one of the units, guys. Obviously, that helps us tremendously. I'm going to turn Major General Boussillet's 1st Foot Battalion and open fire here on the Garde-Voet 2nd Battalion. And we'll try to get another unit here. But, of course, we're going to be blocked, as far as I can tell, by all of these other guys. So maybe we should turn them around and get prepared for the possible attack over here on Grove Island. In fact, I'm thinking maybe we should have sent some men to Grove Island. Maybe we still can. To try to stop the enemy from crossing as much as possible. Okay, that enemy unit dispersed. They've run back to their farms. They have no interest in continuing. Unfortunately, our unit over here has now been disrupted. So they're definitely starting to make our units consider the possibility of running, and that's not good. It's not going to help us one bit. It's going to make our job a whole lot more difficult. 23-10, that's what I'm talking about. We just need to keep throwing that lead downhill, downrange, or across the river, however you want to see it. And that's what we're trying to do right now to break more and more of these units. So now I'm going to focus on the Garde-Voet 2nd Battalion, of course. And just try to lay down as much fire on this guy as we possibly can. So we can't shoot because our line of sight is blocked by our own unit. And I'm not even sure we can fire at the unit across, but I'm going to remain in cover. I'm not going to take the bait and put myself in a dangerous position. And I'm not even going to move this unit until I know for sure that the enemy is moving forward. So let's go ahead and end the turn. My goodness, that is an unbelievable shot, a huge amount of damage, and that's definitely going to hurt us. I'm actually thinking, I'm starting to see that the entire army seems to be crossing that one location, so maybe we'll turn our guys around and use them as a sort of reinforcing position against the enemy troops. And I'll show you what I'm talking about here in a second. All right, we're fragmented now, not good at all. It is our turn now. Fragmented is one step before breaking. So we've got Major General Boussillet's foot 2nd Battalion. I'm going to turn them around so next turn they could possibly take this position that's currently held by the Earl of Clanricts. I'm sure I'm totally butchering those names, so if you guys know how to properly pronounce them, please let me know. And as I see these guys crossing the river, I really do want to keep firing here, but I think we have to start throwing lead down at these guys crossing the river. We can't let them get too close, but at the same time, we also want to increase the damage on these men right here. We are slowly but surely getting rid of their morale, but once again, the guys crossing the river have first dibs on our musket fire. because we don't want them making it across. If they make it across, we're going to have some very serious problems. In fact, I wouldn't want to send James lifeguards, I was thinking, to maybe flank the enemy. Maybe we should send some cavalry over to Grove Island and flank the enemy and do some damage. I think I'm going to try it. I'll send a few cavalry units. And at the same time, I'll keep some dragoons behind to watch this area. But certainly, this could work in our favor, or it could end miserably in a defeat. Alright, let's get to Grove Island, and we shall end the turn. Devastating shot. Our unit has broken, guys. They can't hold their position any longer. We're absolutely going to have to take their position again because that is the northernmost position towards the enemy. And as you can see, they're already across the river, close to Old Bridge. This makes our job a lot harder. So I'm happy that we turned that unit around. We probably should have had them defending that area long before any of this occurred. So the residual shooting phase. Disrupted. I like that a lot. Disrupting the enemy unit, one step closer to breaking them, and one step closer to a possible victory. So there we go. They're running. They have no interest in continuing the fight. Who can blame them, though? And I'm going to try to get this unit right here, James Foot Guard, 1st Battalion. Oh, we already got hit. And unfortunately, we can't turn. We don't have enough action points to turn, but we can fire. So I'm going to go ahead and fire on this unit, and I'm wondering if we charge, our chances of losing are actually quite high. So I am going to move out of cover here. And turn towards the enemy just to get a nice shot on them. Once again, we'll continue firing at this disrupted unit. I can't help but fire at a unit that's disrupted and possibly break them. As you can see, they are fragmented. And next turn, we'll be over here with Major General Boussolet's foot guard. So that's definitely going to assist us. Let's cross with James Lifeguards and Colonel Sutherland's horse over here to try and face the enemy. All right, not so bad. Also got Lord Dongan's Dragoons. And I do want to keep a reserve force back here, but not many men. I don't see the enemy going this way anyway, so I'm thinking we can go ahead and commit to a full attack. So let's keep moving. And as you can see, our cavalry is completely trying to get across the river here. Let's see what happens in this next turn. Residual shooting phase. Got more of that artillery. Pretty significant damage. Even 7 men down by artillery is not going to be good. And I'm glad they didn't charge our men there. They just fired. That gives us a little bit more of an opportunity to maybe win. But again, this is a very hard campaign to win. For obvious reasons, we are outnumbered. And definitely a very tough battle to win. It actually says very hard on the battle itself. But there we go. We broke another enemy unit. We've disrupted one too. This is looking good for us, I must admit. They're routing, no chance, and the Jacobites now have the opportunity to actually do some damage to the enemy. Now, we can actually charge here and possibly really, really do a lot of damage to these guys, but I'm going to continue firing. I'm not going to charge. I won't be the first to make that move. But fire 45, and at that close range, we can see why we're doing so much damage. We're going to turn. And unfortunately, we can't fire, but we will fire at Brigadier Melanier's Huguenot Foot. Try to do some damage to these guys and maybe break them. Of course, if we can still fire at the Garde de Foot, I am definitely going to fire. So we're going to do that. And maybe fire again at Brigadier Melanie's foot guard here. So we're going to bring our cavalry forward. And I'm trying to avoid the Brandenburg Foot. I wish we could ignore them entirely, but we can't because they could make our day very, very difficult. But we're going to keep moving forward. Colonel Parker's horse is also ready to cross the river here. And let's keep on moving with the Duke of Tyrconnell's horse guard as well. So we're totally across the river with our cavalry now. Very interesting battle, and I really love how the user set this up. But we're going to have to end the turn now and hope for the best. They've already spotted us. At least we can return fire with the Dragoons. And there we go, we've broken another unit, guys. Unbelievable. Hey, don't fire at fleeing men. That's against the Articles of War. I mean, are there Articles of War in this battle? I don't think there are. Nonetheless, these guys are moving forward. That's exactly what I didn't want them to do. And now I'm getting a little concerned that they could be a problem for sure. Okay. Still routing. Now, one thing about this enemy unit routing is I love that it's routing, but it's in front of the unit I'm trying to shoot at. So we're still going to try to hit Kugelmitz foot guard. We want to fire at guys that are actually going to be a problem. So I am going to charge to get a rear flank attack. And it's not only going to drop the enemy unit, but I think it's also going to disperse them because they can't run anywhere, as you can see. And this, of course, means we do have to put some defenses to stop Colonel Kylo Malt's foot. We've got to put somebody here at the northern part of Old Bridge, but it's just not time for that yet. So we'll keep on firing. Try to see if we can't break that unit with our consistent fire. All right, we're going to move Colonel Sutherland's horse forward. We're trying to flank the enemy, of course. Now, if we attack here, we will definitely lose. What if we attack them here? No, once again, it's a loss. So I'm trying to get our guys past these Brandenburg foot units at any cost necessary. Right now, I'm just going to keep firing on them. We'll bring the Dragoons in and just try to hit them on the flank. And we've got the Duke of Tarkonnel's horse. Once again, the chances of a loss are far too great, so there's not much we can do with him, except maybe move over here. But I think we'd be better off actually leaving the Duke of Tarkonnel right there. I don't want to be charged by the enemy units and face some damage. However, we should have brought these Dragoons up, because they can get some pretty good firepower on the flanks of this Williamite force. So let's end the turn. Okay, they are going to try to charge. I was concerned about that happening. They are going to go ahead and try to carry out the charge against us, and they definitely have the initiative. This could be very, very bad for our forces. We started off great, but look at that. Oh, my goodness. This is where the Williamites really start to do well. They've brought forward a huge amount of units, and even though a ton of Williamite troops routed during this battle, now that they have all these reinforcements, that goes down from something like 20% to 14%. So it's going to be a lot harder for us to get that victory, of course. All right, there's some nice reactionary shots. I like that. Okay, and they've also turned towards us. Pretty even melee fight there. So, we could fire at Colonel Calomeres. And over here, I think we could charge, but the chances of a loss are far too great. So we're going to continue firing at Colonel Calomeres over here. Kalamots, excuse me. Again, I'm not going to say these names completely right. Sorry about the dog in the background there. So we are going to charge, guys. This is why I brought Colonel Sutherland's horse. 82% chance of a victory. We've disrupted the enemy unit, and that's going to be very, very helpful for us. Let's also see if we can maybe disrupt another enemy unit. So the chance of a charge here, a chance of a victory from a charge, is actually quite great. But I think they're just out of sight, just out of mind. And at the same time, we're very close to being attacked by this foot guard. I hope that that doesn't occur, but it's a possibility for sure. And this Brandenburg foot isn't helping things. So there we go. Let's go ahead and fire. I'm going to move forward, get a little bit closer. Fire. We're going to bring the rest of those Dragoons across before the rest of the Williamite army arrives. And let's see if we could charge and do some damage. And actually, the chance of a victory is pretty high here with the Duke of Tarkonnel's horse attacking. If we could break them, it's going to really assist us in maybe, just maybe, getting a victory despite all of these Williamite reinforcements on the way. So let's end the turn. Very even melee damage right there, and not enough to break the enemy. And of course, Colonel Parker's horse is just getting blasted by enemy musketeers, so we've got to be very careful here. And as soon as these foot guards get to this side of the river, or just get near our men, I mean, we're in a world of trouble. I'm glad that at least it's going to take them a while to get there, but I don't think it's going to make much of a difference in the battle, to be honest with you, because even if we manage to rout all of the troops that are currently there, it's not going to be enough to secure a victory, and we're still going to have to face masses of the enemy's forces. Once again, melee attack. We're so close to maybe breaking this unit. Fragmenting one of them, that's a good sign for sure. The melee damage here is being very, very even, and we don't want them crossing the bridge. And unfortunately, some of our men threw down their arms and totally dispersed. They don't want anything to do with this battle. And with that Williamite force approaching, I almost can't blame them. They might be cowards, but they're not idiots. Let's go ahead and open fire here if we can. It looks like we can't get any shots off with this force, but what we can do... I was aiming at my own men. What's wrong with you, Agrippa? What we can do is try and get over here with the cavalry, the James Lifeguards, and put even more pressure on these Williamite forces. So as you can see, our chances are pretty low of a victory, but I wonder if we charge here, if we can improve things. Yes, we could definitely improve things by breaking the enemy unit. So there we go, we've broken them. Of course, chasing them to deliver the final killing blow. But all things considered, we're still in a world of hurt here. I'm going to try to get right up close and personal with Nassau, Starbroken, Ottweiler Foot, probably a mercenary unit, and try to kill as many of them as possible. But at this point, we can't fire with these units, so we're hoping that this entire army is going to reach this position and try to face us and not cross over here, which I think is probably what they're going to do. They're probably going to go straight for our position, and with that many men, they can break through no matter what kind of defenses we have. Right, here we go. Fragmented the enemy. Maybe another attack and we can break them. Obviously, if we were able to break both enemies on this side, that would be pretty great. So here we go. We're continuing to open fire, and we just got disrupted by a flanking shot from the enemy. This is going to be tough to deal with. Obviously, with a massive amount of Williamite troops arriving at the same time, it's not going to be fun. And just look at those Williamite troops, guys. Once they get to our side of the battlefield, we are absolutely finished. So we've got to finish this battle quickly. We've got to get an overwhelming victory on the river side of the field to convince these Williamite troops that it's not even worth them getting to the battle, because they're going to be massacred once they try to cross the river. Devastating shots there to the Dragoons. And finally, we managed to break one of the Williamite troops. Of course, one of the things about Pike and Shot that can be frustrating, but is quite realistic, is it's quite common for units to chase a unit that breaks even without orders from their commanders. I mean, there's that rage in battle, that anger, and I'm sure these guys are feeling it. But right now, we would actually prefer if they didn't chase these running units. We need this unit to turn towards the enemy and try and defeat them. So I'm actually going to turn these guys around. And hopefully they'll be able to charge the flank of Brigadier Meloneer's Hujan on foot. They might not be able to. Let's see, what about a flanking charge? Well, the win would be 92%. I'm not sure why it's not letting us charge. Ah, from priority enemy. I see. Well, it's not much of a priority because we're going to get crushed if we try and attack them. So I'm going to go ahead and charge the flank of the Nassau Saarbrücken foot. And this is the first group of reinforcements, and they have broken. Absolutely awesome, guys. Breaking another group of enemy forces is huge here in this battle, but it's not the be-all, end-all of the battle. So I'm going to continue, and I'm trying to think of which way I should go. So I'm going to go continue firing with the Dragoons. Of course, now the enemy is firing at us as well, which makes our job a lot harder. Fire. And I'm going to try to get here on the enemy's flank. Of course, even then, we wouldn't do so well. And in fact, if the Hujan on foot decides to go ahead and start firing, we are going to be in a world of trouble. Let's see what we can do with these guys. Not much until the enemy arrives. We could charge. The chance of a loss is far too great. So I'm just going to leave things as they are and, of course, end the turn. All right, they've disrupted one of our Dragoon units, and 35. Those guys have had to have been training for a tremendous amount of time, because getting 35 kills at that distance is not easy. That battle rages on. I want it to rage on so that we can get that flanking attack. Whether or not it's actually going to work, only time will tell. Oh, devastating shots there. At least our dragoons gave them a little what for, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough. And we could see all of these troops from William of Orange's side are arriving to the battle. I don't believe we have any reinforcements. Remember, we're a small rear guard detachment defending this area. So actually, our chances of victory are very, very small, no matter how you look at it. Auto brakes, it's not good for us. The dragoons have broken. All right, once again. Managed to disrupt the enemy, that's awesome. It's good to see that Lord Dungan's troops have essentially decided to remain in the fight. They have rallied once again, so we're gonna move them forward. We're gonna open fire on Colonel Cambon's foot regiment. And I want to see if we can charge here. But once again, a charge would actually be more of a loss for us. Although the chance of a winner is 8%, and considering that our chances of victory are already pretty low, I'm starting to think maybe we should charge these guys and take that 8% chance. I'm not really sure. I'm going to take it. Who knows? Our men have fallen back, and actually, they're in a better position now, closer to the enemy we're trying to completely break. And let's see if we can go ahead and do an impact charge here on the enemy's rear. Fragmenting them, of course. They have broken, and they have nowhere to go. They're going to have to disperse. Oh, wow. They actually managed to find a way to retreat. Pretty impressive, I must say. We're going to move forward and keep firing at them if we can. If not, that's okay. But I want to make sure that they understand we don't want them back on this battlefield. And if they come back, they're going to have some problems. I'm also going to try to take out that artillery up here on the hill. That's one easy way to get some points. But I'm not sure if it's going to be effective. Also, I think Lord Dungan's dragoons are about to be routed with some devastating fire from Colonel Mitchelburn's foot. But let's see what happens. It's not over till it's over, as they say. Like to see all those enemy troops routing, but I fear that's going to be the last time that we get to see that that sight before we break. And there we go. Sure enough, the dragoons broke. Yeah, they can't stick around for that. There's just nothing keeping them there. And we're going to have to try and just hold out against this massive force. And we can already see that some of the Jacobite regiments are starting to make it across these other bridges. The Williamite regiments are starting to make it across these other bridges. We really thought they were all going to go for the center, but that's not the case. And here we go, even more reinforcements. How could we ever possibly win this fight, you ask yourselves? I don't think there's an answer for that. But of course, things just got 10 times harder. And I think very hard is an understatement. Impossible should be the way to characterize this particular battle. Unless we got some reinforcements suddenly. And look at that. We've got enemy cavalry units getting across the river here. That is going to damage us profoundly. All right. Our units have dispersed, of course. Now, it is our turn, but I'm actually at a loss of what to do. I'm starting to think one thing we could do once we stop chasing these guys is we could take out that artillery position. But now we're seeing that the enemy is going to be going to Grove Island. Some of them are still going to be trying to cross here, but I'm thinking we have to meet them in battle. We're going to have to cross over, unfortunately, and try and bring the fight to them. So we've got James Lifeguards. We'll bring over James' 1st Battalion, open fire on these fleeing enemies. It's not the nicest thing to do, but the fact is we have to take the fight to them this time. They're not going to come to us, and maybe if we can catch them on the flank as they're retreating, we could still manage to make enough of them retreat to secure a victory. Let's see. Once again, chances of a win are very small here, but we're desperate at this point. So this is what I'm going to try to do, and I don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to hit them from here. It's only going to work if they stay in combat, but of course they want to fall back all the time. We'll charge again. The chance of a loss is much greater than the chance of a win, but miracles do happen. Let's see. And at this point, we have nothing on the side to defend except for this tiny group of mounted piquets. At least they got away from this cavalry, which would have totally annihilated them. Let's end the turn. All right, one enemy unit dispersed, of course, making little to no difference in their overall troops routed, just because they have so many troops at this point that the percentage of routed troops is almost insignificant. They could lose 5 or 6 more battalions, and it wouldn't make a single bit of difference. So here we go. They're charging across. Just look at that Williamite force. Unbelievable. We could see during the time period what would make this such a terrifying battle for the Catholics, such a difficult battle. Nonetheless, very, very brave for standing up to a force like this. But I personally would have been in that regiment of men running away at this point as quickly as possible, as quickly as my legs could carry me. Here we go, enemy cavalry crossing. And a lot of them are going to the center of the map, so who knows? I think they're trying to attack on 3 different flanks just to make sure they win. Oh, there we go, 33. Ooh, that's nasty. So we're going to go ahead and try to get up this hill. I want to turn towards this cavalry unit. I want to charge them and push them off the field. And as for these guys, we've got to try and whittle down the enemy army. It's going to be very hard to do that, all things considered, right now. So I'm going to try and open fire. They're going to return fire, of course. A charge would be useless here, but maybe a charge from Colonel Cambon's foot regiment wouldn't be so useless. Because if we get into locked combat with them, with the foot regiment, and hear me out here, then we have a chance of charging them over here and getting a flanking charge, which is possibly something that could maybe not win us the battle, but certainly help us beat that one corps. So I'm going to open fire. I'm going to try and restrain myself from attacking here. But we will send the rest of our forces across the bridge, across the river. Very tiny land bridge. Okay. End the turn. So 2 of the enemy units dispersed. Puts a tiny smile on my face, but I think if you guys watch the Williamite troops routed, you're going to see it hasn't changed one bit. It's unbelievable how many men they have on the field right now. They're getting across to Yellow Island, another small island on the river itself. The horde of Williamites approaches. Oh, another thing I should have mentioned in this campaign, you cannot play as the Williamite forces, you can only play as the Jacobites. Obviously, playing as the Williamites would be way too easy, I think. Now, this is interesting. We actually managed to make one of the enemy units fall back. That's certainly a step in the right direction. Now, let's go ahead and charge this unit. It'll break on contact. No more artillery for the enemy. Is that going to make a huge difference in the grand scheme of things? Absolutely not. But nonetheless, we got rid of them. We don't have to worry about them anymore. And now we know that this particular unit is in some trouble. But I think what we're going to do is turn towards Sir John Hammer's foot guard. Just blast them at this close range. Charging, once again, it would be a loss. What if we charge this unit? That would actually be a win because they're running away. So the Duke of Tyrconnell is going to try and disrupt Colonel Cambon's Huguenot foot. And it would be amazing if we could break them here. It really would help us big time. Let's see if we can move our boys up a little bit more, get a shot. Get behind the enemy here. Unfortunately, we can't turn and charge at the same time, but maybe we can charge this unit later. And let's move Earl of Antrim's foot forward. Unfortunately, we can't fire, but we're continuing to move the rest of our army across for pitched battle against the Williamite forces. It's all we can do. We've got to go for the pitched battle, even if it's not in our favor. Okay, end the turn. Wait a minute, before I forget. Still got the mounted PK. Could the mounted PKs win the battle for us just out of nowhere? Who knows? Maybe they could. I highly doubt it. There we go. Devastating shots from the Williamite forces, and the fact they're in range at this distance shows just how strong they are. So we managed to break another group of Williamites here. And we are charging them, trying to cut down as many as possible. But what the Duke of Tyrconnell doesn't realize is he's running right into a death trap. Especially with all of these forces moving forward. And actually, the AI here is excellent, because you could see that that AI was thinking about crossing. As soon as they saw our troops get on the field, they actually started turning to flank us. And I must say, that is very impressive. So here we go. We've got more enemies moving forward. Tremendous amount of enemies moving forward here. Look at that. This is just a big, giant horde of orange. There's nothing to do about it but wait. Okay, our men are definitely ready for the fight. Prepared to die in the name of James II, but I'm not sure it's going to make much of a difference here. So the charge would fail miserably. It's not going to work. I think all we can do is try to get into cover here. And even here, getting into cover is a bit of a joke. Let's open fire. The only benefit we have is the enemy being slightly downhill here. Now, we could possibly win in this battle, so we are going to charge the enemy, Sir John Hamner's foot. And I'm going to see if charging here would make a difference. Unfortunately, I don't think it would. We'll bring these guys out. They're going to get shot at, obviously, but we're at least going to get to open fire on that foot regiment. What about here? We'll turn towards the enemy unit with Colonel Parker's horse. Who knows? Maybe there's something they can do to assist. We've got almost all of our troops across the river here. I guess in the end we did take the bait, but I don't think we had much of a choice. Let's end the turn. All right, now we're being disrupted, despite the fact that it was actually, we had a greater chance of winning that. You can see that we are being fragmented and disrupted now, and like I said, anything can happen. A lot of the game is based on luck. Obviously, a tremendous amount is based on the skill of the soldiers fighting, which is why you get those probabilities. But occasionally, you do get lucky, and even if it says 8% chance of win, 71% chance of loss, the rest being a draw, you can manage to win. It's very rare, but it does happen, so keep that in mind. If you're desperate, do everything you can. All right, they've disrupted another one of our units, and they fragmented another. And I think in the residual shooting phase of next turn, we could be looking at a devastating loss. Look at that. Just look at how many men are approaching. Actually, I think the way that this creator put these armies together was really well done. They look really pretty on the field. It's just an assortment of different colors, just like it was at the time, an assortment of different flags. Of course, we've got the traditional Williamite flag, but we've got a lot of other flags representing other divisions, etc. And I just think it looks really nice. And at this point, they're definitely chasing our men. Actually reminds me of an old cowboy film where the bad guys are trying to run away. Of course, I think it's very subjective who's good or bad in a war like this, but where the bad guys are running away from the the Pinkertons or the sheriffs or any such lawmen. It just looks like our poor cavalry unit over here, the piquets, are just trying to go as quickly as they can to avoid certain death. Let's see. So at this point, anything we do is going to receive an equally nasty reaction. And as you can see, we just auto-broke. Again, another unit of ours breaking. Just not much to be done there. Let's see if we can charge the enemy here. Yes, we can. So we are going to charge a flank attack on Sir John Ham's foot. The enemy is fragmented. Thinking one more shot to them could definitely break them, but really neither here nor there. We're going to have to see, obviously, if the enemy troops arrive, and they're very close. If they arrive on time, they might be able to break us before we even have a chance to break this unit. Once again, another charge here would be interesting. I'm going for it. I want to break this unit completely. 36, and the unit has broken. Sir John Hammer's foot is going to obviously run away, but now that our men are chasing them, there is a problem. However, it looks like they've also decided to charge this unit right here. Maybe we get a little extra boost for charging, you know, in such a frenzy, but I'm not sure we do. We're going to have to actually watch and wait and see. Okay. Well, those poor guys are finished. Look at that. Our poor Duke of Tyrconnell's horse is surrounded by enemy units here. End the turn. Wow, the shots are devastating at this point. Still, I think, you know, win or lose, we managed to rout a quarter of the enemy army. This being such a large army, maybe not the worst defeat in the world. You know, we really didn't have much to work with. Keep firing, lads. All right, it is our turn. So I'm trying to think if I should turn and face Lieutenant Ginkles. Yeah, we probably should. So let's turn with the mounted PKs. We're just awaiting them. We could get a little bit closer. We're kind of in cover here. So I'm going to open fire with the mounted PKs. At least we can take down a few more Williamites before the battle ends. Maybe make it easier for the rest of our forces down the line. Let's move infantry forward. Ooh, that hurts. Fire again. Good work, lads. Fire again. And of course, the enemy's disrupted us already. We're definitely going to go for the charge. But of course, we had to fall back there. And unfortunately, this Duke of Tyrconnell, he's in that battle frenzy. He can't think properly. So he's charging the enemy despite having hordes of Williamite cavalry approaching. It's not going to be easy for him. Let's see what else we can do. I think that's about it. I'm keeping James foot guards here in the rear to see if maybe they will rally again and get back to normalcy, but it's probably not going to occur. Let's end the turn. Can't wait to see the massive Williamite bombardment on us this turn, because they really have us in their sights, and they could do a tremendous amount of damage. This is actually one of the few Pike and Shot user campaigns, I should say, that talks about wars in Ireland. So it's definitely something that I think you guys could probably work on. There's a tremendous amount of battles in the Glorious Revolution that a lot of you with skill could certainly do a great job on. And there we go. The defeat is coming. We can see now, after breaking that central unit, the rest of the units decided, well, we're not going to stick around either. They started running, and with this massive force, it could happen in one or two turns. But again, back to the original point, I really think that a lot of you guys have the skill level to make battles like this, to make other controversial battles of the time period and of the war itself, and I really think it would be excellent. I always like to check out the community, all of the mods on the community here in Pike and Shot campaigns, and you know, you've got a few of them that just are silly, but a lot of them are really well researched and well built like this one, and I hope that we have more of that here in the future. So there we go, a unit dispersed. Oh dear, it's not looking very good. 46%, once we get that to that 60% mark, of course, we completely lose. I guess we could try a charge. That's what I'm going to go for. At least if we're locked in combat, they can't fire on us. Ooh. Devastating shots. And I'm going to try to hit this unit, but again, it's not enough. Open fire over here. And I'm going to go ahead and get right up close and personal with the enemy, or let's keep running. Go back to Old Bridge. Get out of here and head to Old Bridge. All right, we're ending the turn, guys. All right, so we did actually see an enemy unit disperse. Kind of exciting, but, you know, this guy now is stuck out there like a sore thumb. They're just going to use him for target practice. And it looks like the enemy unit charged as well, and our men actually defended themselves extremely well, managing to kill or wound 45 of them. So they held their ground. 37, we disrupted another enemy unit. Exceptional. But once again, that unit auto-broke. I saw that coming. I told you guys, since he charged that enemy unit and continued to charge, he really was leading himself into a death trap, and that's just unfortunate. Do you have any more reinforcements? I wouldn't be surprised. As far as unfair battles, this one would definitely be up there. Of course, there is generally always a way to win a pike and shot battle. I think in this case, maybe we should have stayed across the bridge. I don't think it would have made that much of a difference because they probably would have flanked us from the other parts of the other islands. But staying across the bridge would have probably gained us a few more casualties to the enemy. And also, defeating that enemy force initially very quickly would be, I think, the only way to win this battle. Sort of tricking the oncoming Williamite army that it's not worth a fight, that we are far superior. But, of course, that didn't happen, unfortunately. So let's go ahead and charge. We're getting into hand-to-hand combat here. We're already being charged on this side. And we'll charge over here as well. At this point, the safest place to be is either off the field or in hand-to-hand combat with the enemy. Because at least in hand-to-hand combat with the enemy, we can't be attacked. They can't fire at us because of the fear of course, hitting their own men. So that's quite interesting. We'll put our unit at Old Bridge, and then I'm going to turn and hold Old Bridge to my death if need be. Okay, the battle continues. There's going to be some nice casualties at the end of this battle, even for the enemy, because we definitely managed to put up a decent fight. But let's see what those casualties turn out to be. 40, there we go. It has begun. Our unit is fragmented now. And remember, if they get to 60%, they win the battle. It's that simple. If they can break one of our units this turn, the battle is theirs. The fact that we've managed to hold out this long should in itself be a pretty decent situation. As you can see, a lot of the units are headed for Old Bridge enemy units. There we go. That's an auto break. Another of our units broke. I think that's going to be the end of the Battle of the ˈbˠoːn. Really happy that you guys showed up to watch, and make sure to hit that like button and comment down below, especially if you want to see more battles like this. Of course, a very happy St. Patrick's Day to you all. And let's just take a look right here at the casualties after the battle. I'm curious to see what they're going to be like. And who knows? We've actually managed to get some enemy casualties, maybe slow down the Williamite army. I don't think anyone expected us to win, and that's kind of how it played out. So here we go, 57, 81, melee phase. Yeah, we're definitely finished. 81% of our units, most of our units are dispersing. One of them just auto-broke, even without a fight. He's just like, you know what, forget this, it's not worth it. Although, incredibly, James' foot guards never broke. They stayed in combat the entire time. They turned away and disrupted two enemy units just by defending themselves. So I must say that James' foot guard did extremely well. So there we go. Our men have lost heart. We cannot conceal that this was a defeat. Now let's take a look at the enemy casualties versus ours. So 714 enemies were killed. 1,439 were wounded. 324 were captured or deserted. That's pretty nasty. As for our side, 916 killed, 1,131 wounded, and 921 captured or deserted. Now, all things considered, I think we got more, we actually managed to wound more of the enemy than they did of us. So I don't think that was such a bad battle. But tell me what you guys think in the comments down below. Once again, happy St. Patrick's Day. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.